Hey, boys and girls, it's Mad Hatter here again with yet another YouTube video. And this time we're going to go through the setup for the software on the VKB F14B grip along with the base. Specifically for that controller. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and jump right into it here, and we're going to go to the VKB website. We're going to go to downloads. This is a very easy piece of software setup, so there's nothing to fret over it. There are a few caveats to go over though. There are two boxes. There's an orange box, which is the older box, and then there's a black box. The older box is a Mark 1, and the newer box is a Mark 2. It's black. It's actually a black box. So these do not refer, the Mark 1, Mark 2 do not refer to your bases. It's just a reference to the firmware boxes for your setup. And that's all the references for. So there are three pieces of software that you are going to need. You're going to need to download the VKB device firmware. You're also going to need to download the VKB device configurator. And you're also going to need to download the Z bootloader. And those are the only three pieces of software that you're going to need to download. Now, the orange box is when you look at some of your software is just going to start with black box. The actual black box is going to start with black box Mark 2. I'll show you here in a few minutes what I mean. So I already have the software already downloaded, and you're going to want to make a VKB folder to put this software in so you know where it's at. And you're going to want to delete the archived pieces of software that came along with this, and go ahead and just delete them. You're going to want this folder, the VKB device configurator, the Z bootloader, and keep the Z configure INI configuration setting. So what you're going to do is you're going to click on the VKB device configurator. Then you're going to come up to the VKB and Joy 32. And you're going to click on the bootloader. And it's going to show after you got everything all set up and you got everything plugged in. This is if you just have the VKB F14 controller. If you have something else hooked up to your base, you're going to want to unplug your firmware box from power before you change out your controller. And then once you got your controller changed out, then plug your power back into your firmware box. And then once you got everything all set back up again to whatever controller you want set up, this is basically for any controller that you want set up. and you see the green light, you go ahead and click on this little button here with the three dots on it. Now, this is what I mean. When you see just black box, gunfighter, blah, 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 whatever, this means that it's just the, this means that it's the orange black box. When you see black box mark 2, that means this is the new black box, the actual black box. So I have the F-14B controller already set up on my base. So what I want to do is I want to click on the black box mark 2 gunfighter F-14 here. I click on that. I have it, the device connected. I have it showing in the window up here. And it's good to go. Green light. Go ahead and flash it. Program's running. It is flashing. Almost done. Okay. Now, once that window disappears, I want to go ahead and click on VKB Device Configurator again. Then click on what I have connected to my base, which is the Gunfighter F-14. You see it pops up here. Everything's all set. What I want to do first now is I want to hit default. All the data will be lost, replaced by default values. Are you sure? Yes. Okay. Everything is at default. Now, need to calibrate the controller. Click OK. Start calibration. Test. Access. Kind of did it backwards there, but start calibration. Now I want to check my access X. So I take it all the way over, all the way to the right. Don't worry about anything else that's moving because that'll fix itself. Do that a few times without forcing your stick. And then I want to check my Y-axis. Do that a few times. Don't force your stick. Go back and forth. And then I want to check my rotation X, which is for my DLC. Okay, now I would check my rotation Y, which would be for my Z-axis, which would be for my rudders, but that would be my twist. But since I have my screw in for my twist, and since I have rudder pedals, I don't have to check for that. So what I would do then is this in calibration. And then I would go back and check my calibration after that. Everything seems to be pretty much okay. So then I want to go to my buttons and my POVs and check all my buttons on my stick. I want to check my trigger, detents 1 and 2, my ordnance release button, my trim hat button, my off, my guns, my sidewinders, my sparrows, and my phoenixes, and let's see, my autopilot, and my paddle switch, and everything seems to be working pretty much perfectly. And that's, and my DLC on off. And then, '16 is pretty much standardly on all the time. So that's pretty much it as far as setting up your F14 stick. That's it. That's pretty much the basic on how to get your stick up and going. As far as everything else, there's you got profiles that you can go through, logic accesses and physical accesses. You've got global stuff, which I haven't been through yet. Other settings, actions. And if you want to, let's see here, test actions, you can save this particular profile action. You can save this profile if you want to. You could save, I mean, you can do a settings for all kinds of different buttons for a different profile on your logic accesses and your physical accesses and stuff like that. And you can come over here to your actions and you can save that particular profile so you don't have to redo it. Like, say, for instance, if you got a gunfighter controller hooked up to your base and you got a profile for that one, and let's say, for instance, it's saved and you go switch to a Cosmosima or something like that and say that one is saved, and you want to switch back to your gunfighter, and oh, Lord knows you don't remember some of the functions sometimes, and you put it back on and you can come over here and you can load it and go to another screen. And you can, like, say, for instance, under here, you would have your file name that you saved that particular profile. You can click on that and open that, and that would start that profile for that particular controller. So that would, you know, that saves a lot of time and a lot of hassle and heartache. So that's it. That's pretty much it on how you set up the software. It's nice and neat and fast. It's very intuitive, straightforward. I love it. I'm sure you will too. It only took me maybe about 5 minutes to get my stick up and running. So hope you enjoyed the video. Please smack that like button and hit the subscribe button if you would, please. It helps out the channel. Leave a comment. You know, tell me I suck or whatever. What? But this is Mad Hatter, and we'll catch you later. Bye.